Last season, we made history by securing our promotion to Liga with a whopping 90 points in the bag. But the naysayers thought we were headed straight back to Ligue 2. We added some serious firepower to the team with the additions of Brian Alcocer, Iago Puig, and the surprise loan player, Hendrik. And let's not forget about extending El Shaddaïl Bichiabou's loan from PSG. But, as with every team, some players had to say goodbye, like Aruna Sangante, who left to Watford, Mehdi Berama to Stuttgart, and Artur Demar to Rennes. We made a bold move by giving a chance to the young Serbian goalkeeper Dimitri Stevanović. August and September were just a warm-up for us. A tough game against Auxerre ended in a draw, but Bordeaux was no match for us, with Filip Jagiełło, José Izquierdo and Brian Alcocer scoring for us. However, Ligue 1 competition quickly reminded us that we were in for a challenge. We took some tough losses against Nice, AS Monaco and Lille, but we bounced back, scoring 5 goals against Troyes and Toulouse. October and November were tough, with our first game against powerhouse PSG. But hey, at least we scored a goal, right? December brought some surprises, including a thrilling 4-4 draw against Olympique Lyon, a win against Lens, and a close defeat against Olympique de Marseille. The winter transfer window brought in some fresh talent, with Robert Popa coming in as a first-choice goalkeeper, Kelvin Gamia on loan from Eintracht Frankfurt, and Nicola Iliev on loan from Internazionale Milano. The Coupe de France semi-final saw us going against PSG. Bruh. But it's best never to speak about this game again. Despite some bumps in the road, we secured our spot in the Europa Conference League. But the real shocker was that we were pushing for Champions League qualification. And let's not forget about the future of Le Havre, with young talents like Elvis Macon, Kylian André and Patrice Levavasseur coming through the youth intake. The final game of the season was a nail-biter, with a win against Auxerre and a loss for Nice, securing our spot in the UEFA Champions League. Alexandru Golovin opened the scoring against Nice and Farid El Melali followed suit. Alexandru Golovin scored his second goal against Nice right after, and Brian Alcocer sealed the battle. The Champions League anthem was going to be heard on Stade Océan next season. The fourth place meant that we had to play two qualification games, but European football was on the horizon. So strap in and get ready for the ride.